Imagine in the future a situation where rescue workers can arrive at a scene where there's been some kind of a disaster, and they need to be able to assess as quickly as possible where people might be in that scene that need help, and they need to potentially deliver equipment or other types of necessities to the environment as quickly as possible. My name is Stephanie Gill. I'm a professor in the area of computer science at CES at Harvard, and I work in multi-robot systems. We imagine robots being an important counterpart to the humans to be able to actually do both of these things. One, assess the environment. So get out there, get information as quickly as possible, and understand how to navigate through the environment by potentially sensing signals, such as communication signals that could be coming from a person or a victim's cell phone, and be able to send that information back to other auxiliary robots that can follow, like in the case of our ground robots, that can follow and provide additional assistance, which could be bringing supplies, it could be gathering more information, or it can be testing the safety of the environment, which can then be information that the human responders can use to more effectively organize their rescue efforts. So there are many challenges in getting robots to work together. Two big challenges are, one, getting robots to understand their environment. So how can they gather information about the environment and about other robots that they might be trying to team up with in order to be able to act correctly and behave correctly in the environment? So that's one big question, and that's the question of sensing and perception. The other big question is the question of resilience. Just the way that we know that hacking and vulnerabilities exist in internet systems, the same is true for multi-robot systems, because they are essentially computers that are moving around through the environment. And their actions and their behaviors in the world rely on their algorithms that they're running on board and the information that they're getting from other agents or from the environment. And so if that information is corrupted, then these systems can be vulnerable. And so in the lab, we look at how can we make these systems more resilient such that they behave correctly even if their data is compromised.